Anything you want to say to the people?
Many things, many things.
Disorientated, should have just rested. Called your phone when I should have just texted. Lockdown, should have just Tetris. Retail therapy, should have.
So I spent the last few weeks in Maryland with family. I did a little bit of work, but mostly it was just time to think and reflect on the year and think about the goals I have and how to just like get my brain in one place and set it. And one of the realizations I had is I've been flirting around with this idea of the second channel. I've been doing podcasts on this. I've been doing all this stuff and it's been cool. It's been fairly successful. Like last year, I think our podcast had like 70,000 plays, which is, it's a lot. That's crazy. That's with like not really giving it much attention, right? And so I know that there's people that want this like more raw and unfiltered type of content, and I love it. It's fun to make. It's not that, you know, it's not that hard to create. And so I thought a little bit more, and I think I'm entering the stage of my life where I have to plan a lot more things, and that's what 2024 is like planning and then executing. Because a lot of times, like, I've known I want to make YouTube videos on the main channel, I've done that, or maybe I want to do a podcast and go do that, but I haven't really, like, thought about it before actually committing to any one thing. And so I spent a lot of time thinking about what I want to do and what I want to create on the second channel. Start off as, like, Minecraft videos, and then now then a podcast, and, like, what am I doing, really? And so this was also in tandem with launching my blog, wholesomesimon.com, and a lot of the writing I've done and all these ideas I want to share, and realizing that I should use this channel as a place to do that. No promises, but yeah, I just ordered a fisheye lens and I want to make really easily digestible vlogs about random topics that come up on this blog, just things I write about. It's almost like a companion piece to the writing. There's this concept I've been thinking about, and it's that a lot of time we put so much pressure on this video to be the best it can be and have such a high standard, but at the end of the day, odds are it's gonna be someone's favorite video. Any piece of content you put out there in the world that has meaning, that you've put a lot of time in, it's gonna be at least one person's favorite video. I think about the videos from the YouTubers I used to watch and the things that stand out, and you hear it all the time. Creators are like, oh, like, it's weird because the videos I work on the least, like, people seem to resonate with the most, and sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Because the thing is, we can't really know what people think about a video or how much it impacts them. And so thinking about like the videos that really inspired me in the moments from these like small vlogs, my friend Elliot Choi, made a video where at the end of this random vlog, he talks about like life paths on a whiteboard. I remember that really impacted me. I remember I used to watch this YouTuber Sneeko before he went totally insane and just trying to play the game for clicks and everything. You guys probably know him as what he is today, like the misogynistic streamer. But back in the day, he used to make really artistic content. That's what inspired the fisheye. And I know for a fact those vlogs that he was creating weren't high quality. He wasn't thinking about them that much, but they really impacted me and they inspired me. And so this realization that like a video you create, while you may have a higher standard for yourself, just putting the idea out there, it's gonna impact someone and it's gonna be someone's favorite video. That's what I'm taking into this next year, and that's what this channel is. It's making videos that may not be the craziest high quality production, but spread ideas, and I think there's something valuable about that. Today's January 4th, just got back from the gym, and let's have a good day. Currently back home in Michigan. It's the first day it's actually like snowing, which is really fun.
Yo, this is for all my Korean viewers out there. Hong Sam. If you know, you know. Back when darkness was all I had to hold, I smoke a bag of weed all on my fucking own. And all them baddies on my favorite rappers rapped about never made sense when the words played in my fucking house.
I want to show you guys something that I think is really funny that I saw the other day. But basically, this was a bedroom that I stayed in during my gap year. When I decided to leave college and pursue YouTube full-time. At the time, I had like 20,000 subscribers or something like that. But I mean, it wasn't like that crazy of a long shot. I was running a brand at the time and I was able to financially afford everything. But like the biggest goal I've always had always been to create YouTube videos, to create films, to document my life. And you know, at a certain point on TikTok, you get really sick of only having 60 seconds to tell a story. Like there's an art in that and there's a time and place for that. But you'll hear it from everyone that is on short form is like they want to make YouTube videos, and there's a reason for that. Basically, I made this sign. My bed was right here. And I made this. It's kind of cringe, but like, I don't know, there's some fire to the like grind or whatever, I guess. And it's kind of, I like keeping this up here because it's a moment in time. It says, you have 1 year, close the gap, 100,000. And this is a reference to Ira Glass and his quote about closing the gap. And then, yeah, I didn't end up hitting 100,000 subscribers within that year, actually, but It sent me on that path, and maybe you could argue that it's like superficial, that like, okay, he's just looking to make 100,000 subscribers or reach that milestone. But for me, it's been something that I'd been looking up at for the last like half of my life, since I was like 10. And so that's part of the driving factor. And I remember having like 100,000 subscribers as a goal on my goals when I used to do that every single year, and I wouldn't hit it every year. But finally it worked out last year. So yeah, I think this is funny.
I just keep this up because the idea was wake up and like turn left and look at this.
It's kind of not healthy maybe, but like just having to work hard and aim at these goals has always been just something that's been in my head.
I think what's funny is like this up here as well. I made that in like eighth grade, mostly because I was like hyped at baseball and I wanted to be like a great athlete, which obviously didn't end up happening. The idea was like you wake up and you look up.
I never really looked up at that, to be honest, but yeah, that's also another thing there. And okay, there goes the guitar.
Best coffee in the world.
Yeah. If you guys don't know, I posted on the main channel about the entire story, but a few weeks back, we officially launched Sunny Day, which I'm a part owner in, and I've developed over the past year with some of these really close friends and mentors of mine. But yeah, it's an outdoor coffee and matcha brand. Here's the matcha. But yeah, I guess for me, the idea has always been like, how do you get more people outdoors? And how do you do that within any sort of content I create? I mean, for me, I started out making a lot of mental health content, focused around like, okay, how do we help ourselves through like anxiety or depression or these things? And I've told this story before, but like that became unsustainable. And I realized like, I'm not a clinical therapist. Like I can't really speak on experience that I haven't had yet. And I was like 18 years old at the time. I'm like, what am I doing here? And so I remember there was a point in my life where I was super overwhelmed with Keep It Wholesome and running this clothing brand and everything. And I was closing in on burnout. And I go on this road trip with some of my friends, childhood friends from back in Michigan. And that's Project West. You guys have probably seen that video. But I remember like I had a drop that I had to do as soon as I got back. And I would take some pictures where I was stressed out about that. But as soon as I like woke up in the Badlands, or I woke up in Grand Teton and I was out there in nature with people I love, like all those worries dissipated. And for me, like grounding myself in nature has been so important. And that's kind of like what Sunny Day represents, I guess. So yeah, if you guys want to check it out, link in the description. And yeah, that's a medium roast. So start the day off with some coffee. You know it's different when you got the Uline mug. If you know, you know. Chill, no, what? Something I've been focusing a lot on is journaling. I think it's cool because being back home, I have the original Wholesome journal, and then I have the one from last year that I just finished. And now I got this chungus right here, this thick one. And yeah, I've been documenting my life in this. I feel like I've been taking it a little more seriously recently, because usually my journal entries would be, you know, like half a page or sometimes even a few sentences when I wasn't feeling that. And I feel like it's a good principle to just write whatever you can. But I've been writing like 3-page journal entries recently, so I don't know. Maybe it's just more of a tool I need right now in my life. Today's gonna be a super chill day. I have 2 calls with some creators for Creator Camp for our next event that's in February in Northern California. Might hang out with some people tonight, maybe watch a movie. Something that I've been practicing that's been really good for me is I always have this issue where I get super distracted. Like I'm working on one task and I go to email and then I'm working on another and all of a sudden I'm like doing something else. And so what I've been trying to do with the journal and in the morning, I typically journal in the morning, I know some people do at night, is write down 3 primary things that I have to get done that day. Do not allow myself to veer off from those 3 things at all until I'm done with them. Like go from thing 1, thing 2, thing 3. That's been super helpful because I think I lack a lot of focus in that way. And it also just makes me feel like the ball is moving forward. In some way. I think sometimes I get like 10, 12, 13 tasks done in a day and I still don't feel like I did enough sometimes. And I think that's because there's not a strict outline that I set at the beginning of the day of like, these are the things I should get done to have a successful day today. Also, I don't know, a small thing that's also helped is I wrote this in my journal and it's now my wallpaper, but essentially it just says, let's try not to take on the world every single day, chip away. And that's been a helpful reminder for me.
Huh?
You got anything to say?
What up? Fighter, I'm subscribed to his jiu-jitsu coach on Snapchat.
Fasten driver's seatbelt.
Here at the Dexter District Library, one of the finest establishments. Dan, what are you studying for?
I'm working on my flight instructor license.
Crazy. Wish this man luck. It's in a week, he'll know.
Sunday. It's like 3 days, bro.
Free my boy.
This is my favorite one.